All right, so returning, I guess I was trying to discuss manifestations, so I'll do this again. All right, so the manifestations of, it's a story. It's a story created in your own psychic network or whatever. Yeah, it's its own story within your head. Okay. Now, so you can have stories of this person thinks this of you, and this other person thinks that of you. Now, those are your particular rights. Those are your writings. That event is your writing. So when you're saying that this person thinks that of me, that is almost like a stereotyping. You're stereotyping, you're making that generalization, you're writing it down almost as if a title page, a table of contents. So you're writing a book that is how that person thinks of me always. Okay, and so now you have this person over there. That is how that person is thinking of me always. And so you have this person and that person. And so you end up with this, it's a misguided shelter, actually. It's not a home. It's not a place where you live. It's an incorrect foundation. It's an incorrect basis. It is not a house to keep yourself. You cannot keep yourself in those particular sentiments and thoughts because, well, I spent maybe summer vacations with that person, and we had these and these and these discussions, and that's how they feel about me, and that was that swell time. You can't actually hold that to a key. You cannot hold that to a key. Do you understand? You cannot bank on that. That is not a bank account. You cannot say that I put in that much energy, if you want to put it into dollars and cents. That is not a bank account that you can rely upon. I see a lot of people doing that though. They say this is my network with that person. I've networked with them for so many years. This is my network with that person. This is my network with this other person. And so you have this, oh, I am just living in the, what do you call it? The bloated house of these instructions, in a sense, instructions on who I am. That is an incorrect. That is a non-true self. That is not really who you are. That is a little cutesy title page thesis on what the others and you have had in contact all throughout those years, and your representation of what it was. It was perhaps different for them. Maybe not as worthwhile, maybe more worthwhile. You understand? So it could have been a higher energy or a lesser energy to them. A good energy or a worse energy. And so we have that. So you're walking through life and you have all of this padding of that. And that is not a keep, that is not a house, that is not a shelter, that is just a fantasial place. Do you understand? That is a made up event. That is made up. So when you're trying to free yourself and find out who you are, you have to tear down all of that energy, all of those walls from the past, every single association that you have had some kind of belief into. Even trust. Well, that person will always trust me forever. You have to tear that wall down also. That is your belief. That is your false bank account. Okay, so when you believe that your husband is there for you, 10 million times percent, you have to tear that wall down. When you believe your wife, you have to tear that wall down. When you believe it's a friend that you've known forever, or your brother, You have to tear all of that down. Those are non-existent selves. That's a non-existent part of yourself. That is a non-truth. That is a false energy. That is a person who is built on false energy. And you're like, but I have to rely back on those people. I have to rely back on that, for instance. You know, I have to draw back on that bank account. You know, you did this for me and I did that for you. And I've even met people that are like that. They're like one for one. You know, I did this favor for you, you do this favor for me. I do this other favor for you, you do another favor for me. And that's their energy of their relationship. I've met people that are exactly that way. It's very tedious. Yeah, don't lose track on that one. What side you're, what, you know, don't let that, you know, overdo. You know, I still owe my younger brother $75 and I have not forgotten. But anyway, so we're trying to, when we're trying to get through to who we are, who we really are, those are falses. Those are false energy holds. That's a non-durable. So you're going to have to go back. You're going to have to go back and live as. It's an isolate experience to free yourself from all of those things. Yes, it's isolate. But that is the only way. That is the only true way. And it's a hardship because that endures exactly that no trust exists. That the only trust that exists is what you offer in that moment. You understand? You cannot rely on the trust from the others. You just cannot. You can only rely on the trust that you know that you have to give. That is it. You only know your propensity for trust energy. Now, their trust energy is absolutely not something that you can bank on. Okay, so when we're dealing with that, that is one side of manifestations. Okay, now that's trying to get yourself away from that misguided self, that misguided hold. Because when it comes down to it, to certain situations, when it comes down to, well, do I have enough money? You know, if you don't have enough money, you might already see some of those people that you had thought were just huge bolsters to your ego. You may see them just completely vanish out of your life. And you may see others return or come into your life all of a sudden and prey upon you. Prey upon you as if you are something that is a cripple. So now we're dealing with just clearance of those people, clearance of that energy, clearance of their keep. You know. And those spaces I'm talking about, the keep, are your particular manifestations of, you know, your bank account with them, essentially, your hold energy with them. And that can be your parents, it can be your anybody, it just can be anybody. Yeah, and you'll be like, you know, you just like waltzing through your life, and everything is fine, and you're like, but I thought I could always, always, always depend upon that person. And then you find out the opposite. Just all of a sudden, out of the blue. And I'm like, well, what did I do wrong? Well, the reason you did wrong is the manifestation of that story that you kept was so elaborately held that you believed it. You believed that person was there. You believe that that person was going to be your backup. That was wrong. So, anyway, before I get into any more preaching, I didn't mean to preach it, but that wasn't the only manifestation I wanted to discuss. I want to talk about other manifestations. Manifestations of, like, say, we're you're having a story, you know. Gosh, I don't know. Actually, I'm gonna put a rest to the further manifestation discussion, but I'm yeah. I'm not in a manifestation stop, but yeah, there are several other versions of manifestation I wanted to discuss, and it involves the creative story, self-hold. You know, the stories that are held within your own the builds that you keep. You know, this build in your mind, you know, I'm building this particular, you know, it could be, okay, there you are, you know, it's like, if I don't, you know, take a walk every day, you know, I will fall apart. You know, so you let that have like a huge, huge wave of energy. And, you know, maybe that's not true at all. However, when you have that wave of energy, it in a way is a crippling event to yourself. You know, when you're doing the direct ones for yourself, I believe it's an absolute mirror event. And so there you are, it's like, well, if I don't go to the beach every day, or if I don't take the walk every day, I'll fall apart. Instead of, well, I guess I could replace it with something. I could do some sit-ups or whatever. I could work out another way. But instead, it's that hold of that one deal. You know, if I don't do that every day, I fall apart. And so there's those types of manifestations that become, they become a stranglehold of a belief that can hurt you. That can actually hurt you because it becomes so strong that you do not stop to actually think. You don't stop to actually think that, well, maybe there is a replace. You know, and so you're like, well, if I include other people in the replace, when I say other people, other people's advice, if I include them in the replace, well, you know, maybe that would be something. But these strongholds of like that one deal, you know, if I don't go and work out that particular way, I'm going to fall apart. That will keep you locked. You know, locked. So you can even hear and other people's advice and not even hear it. You know, it's just this other energy that you've been headstrong in so long. That's all. And so that's where manifestation can actually come back and get you in health-wise. So yeah, it's the build up. And I'm like, well, I guess the brain itself, you know, you're dealing with it as a strength, as a muscle. The brain is just all these synapses, muscles, you know, so it's used to going there to there to there to there. So it's that same muscle event, you know, of these little, you know, sporadic things that make the full picture, that make the absolute full picture of, you know, whatever, going to the beach every day or taking that walk every day. I mean, it's just like my dad, you know, it just took him forever. To just go out and take a walk down the street. And I've been the advice, you know, and it's just like, well, it's because he was in that stronghold so long that he couldn't do any other type of exercise. It was only going to the beach. He did not believe any other exercise was available, you know, it becomes a wall. You know, it's like a dancer. It says, I can only dance in a ballet studio. That becomes a wall. Absolute wall event. And so what? There's no ballet studio? So you don't have to have any follow through any other way, you know. So yeah, it's this kind of headstrong wall. So that's where manifestations in belief hurt you health wise. So that was, there's just all I wanted to say about, but no, that was just, I have lots and lots of manifestations to discuss. Lots of manifestations. So yeah, they just they go on and on with philosophy and how it can be that's it. The topic of philosophy itself is the manifestation stream, I'll call it. You know, what stream are you on? What is your manifestation stream? If it is a manifestation stream of the decadent disposal of what you think others are hoarding about you, you know, that bank account, you know, that bank account of who you are. You know, she's always going to bring cookies to my house. She will always bring cookies. She will never bring cookies. You know, that type of, that's what I mean by the bank account. That bank account of, well, see, now I got associated with giving and an item. I didn't mean that either. I meant that collection. It's a collection of statistics about you, your stat, your own CIA fact book, you know, your particular fact book. How about we'll call it that? Your facts, and there. So you're going on, and there. Presumptively, no, she will never use red ribbon on a present. She will never give a present. Oh, gosh dang, it's falling into items again. Oh, yeah, I know. It's falling into items again. All right, so manifestations want to fall into items on the jurisdiction of what other people are possibly holding about you in information. Yeah, that's the trauma. That's the drama of this whole situation, is why are we holding so much materialism as a wall? A wall of warmth? You know, is that your wall of warmth? You know, the materialistic wall. Yeah, I can't even believe it. I can't even come up with anything. Everything is so valued into a cost, isn't it? I can't even come up with anything right now. But when we're talking about the not valued in a cost, you know, then it goes back to what she is going to say, or he is going to say. She wants him to go to school. She just wants him to go to school, to university. You know, so that energy is an expected energy. I will give that expected energy. And they will expect that energy back from me. And then we have that repartee. And if that repartee is good, bad, or ugly, well, then so be it. That is that's the expected repartee that will happen, and that's its continuance based upon that energy. And that's your manifestation. It was like, well, you can go at that energy again. You can have that repartee one more time. You can just have the exact same go around, or it can be altered. Or it can be like this, something else. can become another form of energy. You know, do you want that as part of your what they think of me? What I think they think of me is you should go to university. It's a problem when you start to give your opinions start to become an ad, don't they? A collection. Your opinions start to become a collection. And so the actual true manifestations here are the opinions that you're giving out. So that becomes part of your title page, your content page, you know, you're part of your authoring, you know. And possibly, yes, they may expect that. They may expect that. You can't always expect that you're going to have that same repartee moment with them. You cannot always expect that. But you yourself know from if you're always going to say you should go to university, you already know that record of yourself, don't you? You should go to university. You know, if you're not going to change that, it's possible you'll have the same is a conflict or good moment, whatever it was. If they're all in agreement or maybe they're conflict over it. It's possible you're going to have that same, for instance, go on. And that's how, and then we're like, well, I can rely on that, can't I? Even if it's a conflict moment, I can rely upon that conflict moment. They don't want to go to university. All right. Well, then there's a conflict moment that you can rely upon. And so that becomes almost like a heavy weight, a weighted value. You know, and is that, you know, life meaning? I have a weighted value that I for sure have this discussion, and it is an aggression with you should go to university or you should not go to university, you know. And so that becomes a dependence. You know, so we're having a dependent agreement or disagreement. Yeah, so that becomes part of your house, doesn't it? You know, your house of self. I hope I made that a little bit clear. I think it starts when I went through with the university bit, you know, that makes it more clear, because it's an opinion. It's an opinion state. You know, when you're dealing with other people, it's an opinion state. And when you're dealing with yourself, it becomes another issue. You know, it can become a health state. Like I was saying, you know, go to the beach every day and not being able to change. You know, if you don't go to the beach, you fall apart. You know, that type of thing. Or you don't go to ballet class, you fall apart. And all of those things. You know, instead of getting a dog and taking it for a walk every day, you know, it just becomes impossible. You know, simple change becomes impossible. So yeah, so the manifestation self is a danger, is a very dangerous place, because the belief system is so heady, is so hardy, and it's just like when you look at people that are deep into religion, and they are just like fanatical. You have to look at yourself about how fanatical certain things are for you. Like, I have to live here in this Bay Area the rest of my life. You know? Why are you such a fanatic? I have to go to the beach every day. Why are you such a fanatic? You know, so all of those things. Fanaticism. Those are the dangers when you're going out there extra. And you will not... Well, one, you do have to heed advice. You have to take advice on board to a certain extent. You have to weigh its values. Yeah. And she thinks this about me. And he thinks that about me. That weighted value. That is a terrible build of the self. That is a self build that you cannot rely upon. Hope that's clear.